Very good morning to everyone. My name is Mrs. Nazia Ustad. I would like to extend my warmest wishes to all on the beginning of our new academic year. Firstly, I would like to tell you about myself in brief. I was born and brought up in Ilkal, which is located in Bagalkot district. I have done my whole education in Ilkal itself. I have done my post-graduation in MSc Physics. I have been teaching from 8 years. I have served as an academic coordinator along with the teaching physics and maths in one of the best institutes in Ilkal for 5 years. Later, I joined CKIP Women's College in Vijaipura as a physics lecturer. And as you know that, last year I had joined one of the best schools of Vijaipura, that is St. Joseph High School, as a physics and maths teacher. As you all know that, beginning of something new is always exciting. Here I am talking about the new academic session, a next chapter of your life, means a lot of challenges and it depends on you that how you make the strategy to overcome the challenges. Being a teacher, I strongly feel that each of you is different and unique, but just wanted to say you never compare yourself to anyone because everybody is unique and you cannot be good or perfect in every situation. So always compete yourself, learn from your mistakes and always keep practicing, keep learning and keep smiling. And I wish that the year 2021-22 brings lot of brightness in your life. This year, you will enjoy learning mathematics with me.
Dear students, let us throw light on introduction of mathematics. What is mathematics? The word mathematics is derived from the Greek word mathema, which means knowledge, study or learning. Mathematics is a study of quantity, structure and space. It is a science dealing with logic of quantity, shape and arrangement. We observe patterns of this kind in our daily life. Objects or materials or substances are measured with the help of knowledge of maths. We estimate the numerical values in daily life. We get the skill of problem solving through the knowledge of maths. We use probability concept in weather forecast, fractions, time, symmetry, money and geometrical shapes are used in constructing buildings, etc. So, maths has wide scope in our daily life. Maths is classified into three basic branches, that is arithmetic, algebra and geometry. Brahmagupta is known as the father of arithmetics. Al-Khwarizmi is known as the father of algebra. And as you know, Euclid is called as the father of geometry.
Someone beautifully said that it is about becoming a mathematical thinker, not a calculator. The essence of mathematics is not to make simple things complicated, but also to make complicated things simple. Just thinking of maths all give you jitter. Do you get sweaty and a faster heartbeat whenever you approach your maths paper? Let me share with you few quick and simple tips to overcome the maths phobia. Step 1. Accept your fear. It is of importance because without accepting your fear of subject, it will make that this task that much more difficult to overcome. Once you come to realize your fear, you can then begin to move forward. The second step is understand the reason for the fear. Fear of subject is usually due to the negative experience that one must have had with the subject while they were growing up. It could be a bad experience in the school. The third step is start with the basics. Many a times the anxiety of students is due to the lack of clarity in the fundamental principles and concepts. Therefore, it is preferable for students to start with their basics, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Starting with the simple calculations that you can manage will help to build your confidence in maths. The fourth step is learn differently. Students tend to learn arithmetic via rote learning, which is a horrible way to learn maths. Formulas fall out of your head after the exams. No wonder it is important to actually understand what the formula is doing. Talk your way through it, relate to what is said, understand why you use one formula over another.
The fifth step is be patient and be positive. Patience is the key to master mathematical principles. If it is were not true, you would not be able to succeed. The best way to succeed is to not to give up and to keep trying until you succeed. The sixth step is practice, practice, and then practice some more. More students tend to give up only too easily, thus hampering their progress. In order to rid yourself of the fear, you have to practice, practice, and then practice some more. Because you might not like it, but to gain that confidence, repetition and practice is what helps you to overcome your maths anxiety.
Okay, students, now let's check it out. What is the syllabus of maths this year in 8th standard? So here you can see the list of chapters on the screen. Our math syllabus will be completed in two terms. That is, in first semester, you will study these chapters. And in second semester, these. Here I conclude this session. We will continue learning in the next session. Thank you.